Now, we understand right now that retail is having a major problem. I mean, we're seeing a retail apocalypse, and we knew this was coming because we've been tracking this for a very long time. And of course, the corporate media, the Fed, the government, they were all out there telling us that it was the weather and there were other factors that were causing this problem. When we started to look at it and we looked deeply into it, we realized that, well, people weren't working. People didn't have discretionary funds. People didn't have that extra money to go out and purchase the goods. It had nothing to do with online. It had nothing to do with the weather. It had to do with what was going on in the economy. And we need to remember something very important right now. And this is coming out of a retail consultancy, Alex Partners, where they looked at retail, especially the food industry, and a lot of the supermarkets, a lot of the retail chains like Walmart, Target, and others, well, they've been propped up by the food stamp system. Now, think about this for a second. There has been an incredible increase since the Great Recession on the individuals that are on food stamps. Now, the reason these individuals needed to go on food stamps is because the system that we are in today does not produce jobs, does not produce the jobs where you can go out and make a living and you're getting that full-time high-paying job. We know that manufacturing has been decreasing. We know now that retail, a lot of the corporate high-level jobs, they've been laying off. We know that the lower part-time jobs, they've been laying off. And right now, these unemployment numbers, they're completely fake, phony, and false. They're manipulated to make us think that the employment sector is doing very well. But a lot of people have one or two or three part-time jobs, and they're still not making the same as they were before. And there's a lot of people that can't even find any type of work, and they resort to food stamps to help them get by. And we need to understand, because of the way the system is designed, the way the system is operating right now, there's no alternative but for the government to step in. This is how it was designed. Now, a lot of this money has been going to support the supermarkets, been going to support the chains. Now, if we break it down, we can see that Walmart, for instance, well, they take in around $12.7 billion. Now, think about this. If there was no food stamp program and these individuals were out of work, they couldn't find work, or they have a part-time job, these retail stores would collapse. What's keeping them pretty much alive right now is the food stamp industry, which means the taxpayers are paying for all this, for these corporations to stay in business. And I'm not knocking the people that are on food stamps. Many of the people today who can't find jobs or only have a part-time job, who have families, this is the only way they can survive. I understand this. We all understand this because the system right now is not designed to create incredible jobs. Think about all the manufacturing jobs we've lost. Look at all the jobs that are being lost right now in the retail industry, in the corporate arena. It's getting worse. If we look at Target, they receive between $4.8 billion and $5.3 billion worth of food stamp sales. And what's going to happen as we move forward, as things start to break down, and we already know that there's going to be cuts in this area because a lot of the government programs, there's going to be many, many cuts because the government is broke. We're going to have a major, major problem in the retail industry. Forget about online, forget about all this brick and mortar stores. The entire retail industry is going to take a huge hit because when the system starts to really completely break apart, like we're seeing right now, we're going to see things really accelerate. And remember, everything is intertwined right now. We know the government, provides subsidies for many businesses. I mean, if we look at food stamps, we can see this is really like a subsidy for these businesses to operate. If we m remove this, billions and billions and billions of dollars, and people can't find jobs, these businesses will not be able to survive either. So we're going to see a catastrophic event hit. I mean, we're already starting to see it in many, many states: Maine, Connecticut, Illinois, New Jersey. We're starting to see the whole thing completely fall apart, and there's like another 10 states that are right on the precipice of completely imploding on themselves. And when we look at Illinois, we can see they are in a huge amount of trouble right now. And we know that the lawmakers in Illinois, well, they failed to agree on how to compromise all the government's deficits. And we can see right now they're very close to a junk-rated U.S. state. A federal judge, Joan Lefkount, in Chicago ordered Illinois to come up with hundreds of millions of dollars it owes in Medicaid payments that state officials say the government just doesn't have. And Judge Lefkow ordered the state to make $586 million in monthly payments, as well as another $2 billion towards a $3 billion backlog of payments. Right now, the general fund's payable backlog is, what, $14 billion, approaching $15 billion? This is, it's crippling the entire state. And we see at this point that Illinois, they're in a huge amount of trouble. They're collapsing right in front of us. Now, the governor, well, he decided to do something completely crazy. He agreed to hike the personal income tax rate to 4.95% from 3.75%, and the corporate income tax rate, well, that will rise from 7% from 5.25%. Now, is this going to help the situation? Well, most likely not. We know that, like, the Chicago schools, well, they're not going to get fixed. The hikes will not shore up pension plans. Within 1 month of tax hikes, public unions will ask for more money, and people will leave the state. Corporations will start to leave the state. How do we know this? Well, we saw what was happening in Connecticut, where corporations said, okay, we can't make it here anymore. We need to leave. The taxes are too high. We're out. We see in New Jersey, Governor Chris Christie declared a state of emergency in the state and announced a partial state government shutdown. And it looks like the same thing is happening that's happening in Illinois, the same thing happening in Connecticut, the same thing that's happening in Maine. It looks like the legislators, well, they failed to reach an agreement by the deadline for their budget. And right now, police, well, they're turning away vehicles and people on bicycles at the Island Beach State Park in Ocean County. It is closed. And public workers right now, the governor said, don't expect to get any back pay. And we can see that state by state by state, things are completely breaking down. And to take this a step further, well, we have a pension national crisis on our hand. America's pension system, as we know, we've discussed this before, is completely underfunded. And we can see right now that from all these states, Illinois, California, New Jersey, Connecticut, Massachusetts, Kentucky, and eight other states, they're very vulnerable to this pension problem. And there are other states that are teetering on this problem. Now, this is not a distant concern. It is a concern that is already happening. We're already in the crisis. Now, according to data supplied by the Federal Reserve, pensions, public and private combined, were roughly 27% underfunded at the end of last year. And when we look at the data more closely, we can see that America's public pensions, they're in a $6 trillion abyss. I mean, it's absolutely ridiculous. Now, remember, these pension systems, they were built upon the idea that these investments were going to yield around 7.5% annual returns. But because the interest rates are so low and everything else that's going on, the average public pension plan returned just 1.5% last year. The pension crisis in America is a silent crisis. No one's really talking about it until it actually hits. And we can see that Illinois is going to have a problem. Maine is going to have a problem. New Jersey is going to have a problem. California is going to have a problem. Connecticut's going to have a problem. Massachusetts is going to have a problem. These states are all going to have a problem. And there are many more that are going to turn up saying, yes, we also have a pension problem. Because as we can see, the economy today is not doing as well as the corporate media, the Fed, the government wants us to believe it's doing. It is built on an illusion, and the illusion is slowly cracking. It's disappearing. Now, the Atlanta Fed and the New York Fed, they do their estimates on GDP, and we can see that the Atlanta Fed and the New York Fed, they were completely separate and apart. Now it looks like they're converging, and it looks like the New York Fed, their now cast, remains around 1.9%. The Atlanta Fed, their GDP now, well, it has dipped to 2.7%. And it looks like both of these numbers, they're coming to a point where their huge spread before, where one was at like 1.5%, one was at like 3%. Well, that spread is now narrowing, and we're coming to a more of a estimate that reflects what's really going on. Now, remember, this is still manipulated. This is still not the real GDP numbers. And even if we meet at 2% or 1.9% or 1.7%, what they do is they play with the numbers, they revise numbers, and we can see this is what they did to the first quarter. They revise the numbers, and they create the illusion that now the GDP numbers are in line with what the economy is doing. And again, the economy is nowhere near that 3%. We're so far below that, and this is completely manipulated. We need to remember, they recalculated the GDP. Going back to 1929, they added research and development and other things, and they recalculated all the way up to the present time. They also included Obamacare, the Obamacare tax, anything that they can throw in there to make the numbers better. This is what they did, and then they go back and they revise the numbers to make it look like it's a lot better than it really is. But what we see the Fed doing, what we see the corporate media doing right now, they're building the case to convince us, on one hand, that the economy is fine. This is what the Fed does. They tell us that there's, you know, no recession headed our way. There's no collapse headed our way. We're not going to see a crisis in our lifetime. This is what they said back in 2008. They were not forecasting any type of recession. Janet Yellen today said she doesn't predict any type of crisis within our lifetime. So we can see this is what the Fed does. They pretend, they keep us in this illusion that everything is fine. Then we have the corporate media, where part of the corporate media, they're on track to say that, you know, because of Trump's policies and what he's doing, the economy looks like it's slipping. It's not doing as well. And I see in Time, they're talking about climate change. And they're saying how climate change, since we backed out of the climate accord, this could spark another great recession. I mean, think about what they're saying right now. They're grasping at anything they possibly can to convince us of why this economy is going to fall apart. We know why it's going to fall apart. It's built on an illusion. It's built on one gigantic manipulation. Think about what the corporate media did back when retail wasn't doing well, and everyone believed it, except us. I mean, just think back to those times after the holiday season, like in January, February, where they said, well, people didn't go to the brick and mortar stores because it was snowy, it was rainy, it was icy. And of course, this was only happening in one part of the country. The rest of the country was sunny and beautiful, but they tried to convince the country, the world, everyone, that retail wasn't doing well, the holiday season wasn't doing well because it was either too warm or it was too cold, and this is why. Then they went on to, well, everyone is moving to online sales, but when we took all the numbers from online sales and brick and mortar stores and combined them, sales were not really up, because if everyone was switching from brick and mortar to online, the entire retail industry should be incredible. Not happening. All that fell apart. Now they're trying to make the excuse of why the economy is going to be falling apart. And they're saying, well, it's because of that policy. It's because of the cuts in government. Well, it's because climate change. They're trying to create a narrative of why this economy is going to fall apart. This is what we're seeing right now. But we've been following this. We've been tracking this. We know exactly what is happening. We know what the Fed is up to. We know what the corporate media is up to. We know the economy is not doing well, and it hasn't been doing well since 2008. We know the whole thing has been built up and propped up with stimulus. We know the Fed has been dealing in the markets. We know that other central banks in other countries have been dealing in the markets. We know that QE has been pushed from one country to another to keep everyone confused. We know there's a huge amount of treasury bonds that are being purchased. And we know that all these numbers are completely manipulated. The only thing they can show us is the stock market, the NASDAQ, and everything else on how that's improving. But everything else behind the scenes, it's all falling apart. And it's starting to show up in the States. It's showing up in retail. It's going to be showing up in housing. It's going to be showing up in the automotive industry. It's going to be showing up everywhere. And all of a sudden, in all these different sectors, it's all going to come crashing down just like it did in 2008. And it will then pull the market down because no one then will accelerate. And remember, everything is intertwined right now. We know the government, you know, provides subsidies for many businesses. If we look at food stamps, we can see this is really like a subsidy for these businesses to operate. If we remove this, billions and billions and billions of dollars, and people can't find jobs, these businesses will not be able to survive either. So we're going to see a catastrophic event hit. I mean, we're already starting to see it in many, many states, Maine, Connecticut, Illinois, New Jersey. We're starting to see the whole thing completely fall apart, and there's like another 10 states that are right on the precipice of completely imploding on themselves. And when we look at Illinois, we can see they are in a huge amount of trouble right now. And we know that the lawmakers in Illinois, well, they failed to agree on how to compromise all the government's deficits. And we can see right now they're very close to a junk-rated U.S. state. A federal judge who only have a part-time job, who have families. This is the only way they can survive. I understand this. We all understand this because the system right now is not designed to create incredible jobs. Think about all the manufacturing jobs we've lost. Look at all the jobs that are being lost right now in the retail industry, in the corporate arena. It's getting worse. If we look at Target, they receive between $4.8 billion and $5.3 billion worth of food stamp sales. And what's going to happen as we move forward, as things start to break down, and we already know that there's going to be cuts in this area because a lot of the government programs, there's going to be many, many cuts because the government is broke. We're going to have a major, major problem in the retail industry. Forget about online, forget about all this brick and mortar stores. The entire retail industry is going to take a huge hit. Because when the system starts to really completely break apart, like we're seeing right now, we're going to see things really accept. Now, we understand right now that retail is having a major problem. I mean, we're seeing a retail apocalypse. And we knew this was coming because we've been tracking this for a very long time. And of course, the corporate media, the Fed, the government, they were all out there telling us that it was the weather and there were other factors that were causing this problem. When we started to look at it and we looked deeply into it, we realized that, well, people weren't working. People didn't have discretionary funds. People didn't have that extra money to go out and purchase the goods. It had nothing to do with online. It had nothing to do with the weather. It had to do with what was going on in the economy. And we need to remember something very important right now. And this is coming out of a retail consultancy, Alex Partners, where they looked at retail, especially the food industry, and a lot of the supermarkets, a lot of the retail chains like work, and they resort to food stamps to help them get by. And we need to understand, because of the way the system is designed, the way the system is operating right now, there's no alternative but for the government to step in. This is how it was designed. Now, a lot of this money has been going to support the supermarkets, been going to support the chains. Now, if we break it down, we can see that Walmart, for instance, well, they take in around $12.7 billion. Now, think about this. If there was no food stamp program and these individuals were out of work, they couldn't find work, or they have a part-time job, these retail stores would collapse. What's keeping them pretty much alive right now is the food stamp industry, which means the taxpayers are paying for all this, for these corporations to stay in business. And I'm not knocking the people that are on food stamps. Many of the people today who can't find jobs are Walmart, Target, and others. Well, they've been propped up by the food stamp system. Now, think about this for a second. There has been an incredible increase since the Great Recession on the individuals that are on food stamps. Now, the reason these individuals needed to go on food stamps is because the system that we are in today does not produce jobs, does not produce the jobs where you can go out and make a living and you're getting that full-time, high-paying job. We know that manufacturing has been decreasing. We know now that retail, a lot of the corporate high-level jobs, they've been laying off. We know that the lower part-time jobs, they've been laying off. And right now, these unemployment numbers, they're completely fake, phony, and false. They're manipulated to make us think that the employment sector is doing very well. But a lot of people have one or two or three part-time jobs, and they're still not making the same as they were before. And there's a lot of people that can't even find any type of work.